Hi, nice to meet you. Nice to talk to you. Now, why this style of animation?
Oh, I think you want to feel like you've just seen the greatest kids' illustrations in the world, the same way you feel when you open one of those books. We owed it to them, I think, to feel as if they just read a wonderful classic fairy tale, and that demands something different than a lot of CG animation. What do you guys
think? Yeah, I think also the idea to make something that is very sincere and believable, you know, you kind of arrive in this kind of very subtle, maybe sophisticated style in animation was, you know, kind of what we've really been trying to get.
Is it true that you guys literally just finished this up?
No, it's been such a challenge because it is so different. Everything we've done it differently. So we've been breaking new ground, which has been kind of scary because each time we get to a new department, it's different. And so we only just made it. But
color timing was finished last week. So, yeah.
But I think the audience are getting like a whole lot more because of it. It's a very generous, I think it's a very generous movie actually for the audiences, yeah.
So how daunting is it bringing a book that's loved by so many people to the screen?
Well, I mean, the first thing you want to do is capture the spirit of what the author tried to do, and the fact that Kate loves this so much is, I think, something that makes us all the happiest. Yeah, and you, it isn't so much that you need to be literal to the book, but you need them to feel the same things they felt when they read it. The tone has to be the same. The characters have to feel the same. And what lingers with you, I think, has to be the same, you know.
Yeah, and Kate said that it's a compliment to her book, and that you could see the movie first and then read the book afterwards, and you would still love it. And that's a very big compliment. And she came here today as well, you know. And
she's very happy about it. Now, you guys actually let some of your actors work in the booth together? You did that?
That was the plan.
Yeah, we you know, I'd done a lot of live-action movies in which, you know, we'd done this. And so, you know, we talked about it and realized, well, there's no reason you can't do this just because it hasn't been done before. I mean, I've recorded a lot of sound in my life with labs and booms following actors. So we brought all that into an ADR stage, and we actually had props. And I mean, you know, Dustin had a sword at one point. You know what I mean?
Was there a food fight too, or something?
Yes, Kevin Klein and Stanley Tucci ended up, method actors that they are, ended up flinging food at each other. I have to say, I encouraged them a little bit, but yeah, they did.
You didn't get involved in it, though.
I ducked. Yeah.
What do you hope audiences who haven't read the book are going to walk away thinking about this? What story do you want them to keep in mind?
Well, I think it, I mean, the story is about so many things, but a lot of, you know, about all the good virtues, really, that, you know, an old fairy tale gives. And, of course, above all, it's about forgiveness and, you know, I think that's kind of a very strong message that is, you know, something that we hope that...
It's a very hopeful movie, and the book was a very hopeful book, and I think it's one of the reasons that the book surprised so many people and how successful it was. It's like, it's not cynical, and kids and parents love that, and, you know, if we've honored that, and I guess Kate feels we have, then, you know, we're fortunate.